very scary.
This way, representing Kumata, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Umasemata.
So Umasemata then from Uganda versus Imsuit Konarai. Now Imsuit can fight really, really well, or it can be really, really lazy. The last couple of times we've seen him though, I've got to give him credit. He's fought really well, Imsuit. So we'll see.
Umar, he's in very good shape, very solid, very strong. He's been in there with some good fighters. He's lost to Sanchez, lost to Sagadal, but he's been in there at a good class. He's as tough as you come. Obviously, he took some big shots off both them guys. He lasted the five rounds though. But I think, again, if he wants to get a victory, he's going to be up on the top of his game again, Vinny.
I'll tell you something though, Liam, and what I've noticed is there's lots and lots of nations coming in. Uganda fighting Muay Thai now that I, to be honest, I've never seen fight before.
No, Umar's lived in Thailand though for a long time. So he's well schooled. He's been in there with good names, like I said, Sagadal, Sanchez, etc. So, like we say, Imsuit's going to have to. He can't turn up being half hearted like we have seen him. He's going to have to be on the top of his game, but like we say on the last Yokal 5 and 6, he has performed out of his skin.
Well, Liam Harrison definitely keeping his finger on the pulse of the Muay Thai world and fight and noticing all the up-and-comers that could be coming for his title to try and topple the Hitman, to try and sniper the young Harrison that's next to me. Don't you worry, Liam, I'll protect you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Konarai Imwise!
So, makes his way to the ring, a very talented young fighter, Imwise Konarai, who I've seen him fight quite a few times. He had a high tussle against Hasim Banui, who you'll be tussling with very, very soon, Liam, on Yokao 8. And we're going to see, he's a very talented guy, great balance, good skill. It depends what mood he's in, really. If he comes to mess about and as they say in where I'm from, Manchester, at the GOAT, then, you know, it's not enjoyable. But when he fights properly, when he takes it serious, he's got very, very good skills and he's got absolutely superb balance.
Yeah, he has. Yeah. Got some very strong kicks, good clinching, good elbows. As we saw in the last one, he won against Behzad from Iran. He turned up, he was strictly business. He came forward, he came to fight, and that's hopefully what we'll get again today.
He also dropped him as well. It was a good performance. 67 kilos, 40 fights, playing 198 fights. So, the massive amount of skill, experience over the young man, Umasemata. But, nevertheless, Umar is rock hard, as Liam often says. And he's here to do the business, so we'll see.
Yeah, he's very tough, he's very strong, he's built like an ox. Yeah. So it should be very interesting.
So, white shorts, Umasemata. And in the yellow shorts, Imwise Konarai. Yokal 7, ladies and gentlemen, bringing you the very, very best shows. And if you want to know what's going on in the Yokal world, yokal.com and also at Yokal Boxing. We'll be tweeting on a regular basis to give you the information of some of the things that are coming up very, very soon. And a great team we have with us. So, Stefania and the gang, Filippo, and all of the team in Thailand, just really bringing us the very, very best shows, not only in Thailand, but around the world. And we'll be giving you information on what's coming up very soon. As I said, Yokal 8 will be from England. And some other sneak previews of what's coming up in the future. But Liam, really excited to see Umasemata, because if you say he's tough and he can fight, then I just tend to believe you.
Yeah, he is. He's very tough, like I say. He's fights with Sagadal and Sanchez. He took some big shots in them. He was game. He came to fight and he took them both the distance. So, like we say, Imsuit's going to have to be on the top of his game. No messing about. He's going to have to really be sharp from the off on this one.
So we'll see then what's going to happen. With all the action coming up. Round one then. Looks in good shape, doesn't he, Samatha?
Very, very solid.
Do you know where Samatha trains?
He does live in Thailand, I think, but I'm not actually sure which gym he's at the minute. I think he's moved around for a few different ones. I'm not sure which gym he's currently from.
Solid, doesn't
he?
Really,
very
really
solid.
That bangle, man, that bangle!
It's like James France a little bit.
Yes.
From behind, short.
Hey, short on the build.
That was a nice spinning kick, that was.
Where the legs of Samatha is into it.
Samatha trying to work the legs of him, so it's back to
him. Yeah, nice return low kick, tip for tap.
It's going to be a good fight, this, isn't it? You can see already this is going to be a good fight, too. Two skilled instruments, so having a look at the minute. Sneak elbow that he tries. Samatha.
Yeah, Samatha's no mug. Like I say, he's been in there with good names.
Quick hands as well.
Yeah, he's...
What weight is that?
67, I think. Nice one to the body as well there. So into it, he's going to have to be on his game.
That was really nice, wasn't it? A body kick and then a push kick on the same.
He's very flexible, Izuma. I've seen him, like we saw the spinning kick. I think he made a very tight one or some sort of kick up from background to start with, but he's... Very skilled in Muay Thai, he's strong, he's lived in Thailand, so he's very dangerous.
Got good footwork as well, just stepping around him so it just having a look still here.
Yeah, he knows Umar's dangerous, he's having a good look at him.
He's taking him seriously, isn't he? Nice scoring body kick from him, so it just through the guard of Samatha. Body shot and a right. I tell you what, you know, I miss out on these, don't I? And I'm so glad to have you with me, Liam, you know, because you've got so much knowledge about these fighters that are coming up, and it's great to see some good fighters coming through.
Yeah, definitely. We've seen Cameron Picking tonight, we've seen Umar now, and we're going to see Victor Ngabe later on. 20 years old is Victor, who's fighting Sanchai. Very good, he's had about 50 fights, lived in Thailand a long time.
And also just seen Lomani. Saw Hiron, he was superb with an elbow tries. Good block there from Samatha though. Good defensive skills from him. Good round, very tip for tat though.
Yeah,
very tip for tat.
Tip for tat. I think Imsuit were just having a little look at Umar there on that first round. Umar started a bit quicker. It'd be interesting to see what happens in this next round as the fight goes on. I think Umar may have shown Imsuit there a little bit too much of his arsenal early on. I think Imsuit was holding back a little bit there. We'll see him spring to life in this next round.
Yeah, I see the thing is that Imsuit will use the body kick more, because when he threw the first body kick, he sort of walked off with the team thinking about it and thought, okay, that maybe that's the technique to use. But I tell you something, like I said earlier, like I just said a moment ago, some of the new to me, and I have to be honest, and I'm sure they're new to a lot of the ladies and gentlemen at home. Victor, I'm looking forward to watching this Umar Samatha. And you know, I don't know nothing about Jeffrey Rivera or Samuel Andush, who's coming up later on from France, so it's going to be good. But here's some of the action.
Left kick coming down from Umar.
Really nice performance.
Nice body kick back from. So it, like I said, tip for tap. Beautiful elbow there, landed right on the forehead. Took that well, did Umar.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, wow. I mean, it's actually exciting for me, because you know, you can get bored with the same names, can't you, to be honest? You know, you get to see the same names over and over and over. These new kids on the block really excite me, and it's exciting, especially in the 6-7 kills, some good fighters from England. Brad Stanton,
Reece McAllister. Reece, probably one of the most exciting divisions we've got.
Definitely. So round two then in the yellow shorts, Imwasit, and in the white shorts, Semata from Uganda.
Here we go, second round. He looks quite happy to fight on the back foot. I think he knows Umar's strong. He didn't want to meet him head on. Dodging that.
Standing his ground now in Sweat though, isn't he? A little bit more. Good teep from Semata.
Solid low kick.
Good block as well from him, was it? Sneak elbow through the guard of Semata.
Do it still not?
Still not doing much, is he?
No, he's not. He's still having a good look. I'm sure he's waiting to try and counter Umar on the way in. Beautiful back elbow.
Good kick back though from Semata. Yeah, really nice. Knee to the body from Umar. Really well though, isn't he?
Yeah, he's seen that, but lifting the leg up in the clinch. He's not quite as explosive as we've seen him in his last two performances, but if he did fight that, it might be a bit mistaken. It's not as strong as Umar is. Umar just beckoning him on there.
Tries a left elbow and the right elbow, left jab on the right elbow, but Samantha blocked that really well.
He actually in the middle of the ring, so it's quite a bit of fight off the back foot. Nice left kick there for
really
Umar,
nice
beautiful timing.
Up. Yeah, good skills out of the back leg. What's Samata ahead of you? Already, really?
I think in this round, I think Imsuit has just picked him off just a little bit better. He did well in the first round, but there, especially with that throw.
Yeah, especially with that, as I said,
he's just nicking this round.
As I said that, he did do that, so shut me up. Defending himself well though.
He knows that Umar's very strong. He don't really want to get involved too much. He's doing just enough, and that's what it is at the minute, just enough.
He is, but I tell you what, he's impressive though, isn't he? Semata.
Yeah, very. Yeah, like I say, just
nice.
Just nick the round.
Nice. And you know what? Honestly, and I'm saying this with a hand on heart, you know, as first of all, I'm a fan of the game, really am. But I tell you something, I'm really impressed with this guy, this Samat. I've never seen him before. Yeah, you're going to have to keep me more informed, Liam, keeping him to yourself.
Like I say, he's lived in Thailand a long time. He's been fighting a lot of the Muay Thai Warriors shows. He's been on some big names and stuff. He's an experienced guy. So obviously we don't get to see much of these shows over here, and Yokawa bringing these fighters to us now, Vinny, so we're very lucky.
Yeah, we are indeed. And if you just joined us on Yokawa 7, we just seen some very, very close fight. Just got him to it ahead. He didn't at first, but then the round started to just tip towards him, so it. But I tell you something, do not write Umar Semata off from Uganda, because he means business. Meaning business later on, the knockout specialist himself. Ekipotso Klimi, the strong and heavy-hitting southpaw, the very strong Akide Sitsompinong is coming up later on against Samuel Andouche from France. Suadam Bouanjai, he's coming up later too.
Right, kick up high there, good defensive skills from Umar though.
So much better to watch to see him so it uses skill though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
So much better.
He had got caught up in the showboating and being a bit lazy in previous fights, as I said, but he is, I think he's might have left that behind now, Vinny, just meaning business on his last few that we've watched.
He tried to do that in Milan twice, didn't he? It didn't really come off. It paid off for the crowd enjoyed it, and he enjoyed the dancing, etc. But this is so much better from my perspective anyway. If you like disco dancing and messing around, then go to the disco and watch people that mess around.
Yeah, I think also I don't think he'd get away with it with Umar, to be honest.
No.
So he has got to be on top of his game. He's got to be careful. And we've seen a good performance from both of them.
Yeah, we'll see. So, round three then.
Hey! Beautiful scissor knee there, brought up to the chest. And a nice kick back from Umar.
Good speed as well.
He's very fast.
Yeah. Him so it just negating everything. Look at the balance of him. Absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, just
really?
Holding on one leg and having three good right hands and a good body kick, good scoring, good left knee as well. Nice and fast. Like I said, he knows just what to do. As Umar's coming in just to score the points.
I'd like to see him so it come over and face Brad Stanton or maybe even Reese McAllister.
Yeah.
The future Yoko show.
Definitely very good. So look at the balance again. Look at that.
So
beautiful.
Nice. Beautiful.
And again, and he's just starting to pull away on the scorecards now in this round.
That's what I said, his asset. His asset is his balance.
He's got good timing as well. Yeah, he has just pulled, started to pull away on the scorecards a little bit here. He knows it as well. Umar still pushing forward. A beautiful timed elbow there from Imsewit. And another one. Umar's very tough though. He's coming forward. He's still trying to make a fight for this. Good knees coming in from him. Could just be, but it's just a little bit too late.
Yeah, one
more. Imsewit has pulled away quite a bit on the scorecard. He's just trying to stay away now, protect his lead. Turn from Imsewit. Either way though, no matter what the outcome of this fight, Umar has put a very good account of himself on a big show, so I'm pretty sure we'll see him again on some of these Yokao cards here in Pattaya. So just trying to stay away now. Protecting that lead. Very good defensive skill from him as well, just lifting the leg to block. Very good performance. Both guys, Umar still marching forward, looking there. Try and pull something back here, but Imsewit knows he's done just enough. And there, the final bell goes. Both fighters raise a hand, but I'd give that to Imsewit. Like I said though, I'm sure we're going to see more of Umar on these shows and the big shows. He's been in there with some good fighters. He put another very good account of himself in there. And we'll look forward to watching Imsewit again. That's looking like three in a row now on the last Yokao shows for him. Very good performances, Vinny, on the last three shows now.
Yeah, absolutely superb. He's redeemed himself in my eyes.
The winning point is from Red Corner, Pornarai in
Really, really good performance that was. Just a superb performance, wasn't it, from Samata? Just really nice, good, but a good performance by Insua, who just nicked it in my eyes. But